gets beaten up by his parents. Think about his condition. This, my friends, is corporal punishment. A very good afternoon to one and all present here. I strongly disbelieve in today's resolution. Why is this? But before that, who are the stakeholders? The stakeholders in this resolution are the children, 40% of the world's population. We all are influenced by corporal punishments, and if it's not carried out. Why do I believe that this sparing of these corporal punishments are not spoiling the children? Here's why. It's said that love and compassion is the key to the future. It is also said that love and compassion is the only way through which a child can grow both mentally, spiritually, and morally. We have seen that in so many countries, these corporal punishments are being banned because they're exploited. Children do not grow. Many researchers have also been conducted that children who are in a stress-free, controlled environment perform better and develop better personalities than people who aren't, than people who are in a stressful environment. Look at countries like Finland, who have abolished punishments of all types. They focus on guidance-based teaching, which is the key. And guess what? Their children develop better personalities and have higher grades than any other children in the world. This is why corporal punishments should not be practiced. If corporal punishments are practiced, they do spoil the children. This is why. The child is instilled with fear of his parents. He is terrified of facing his own parents, and he is scared of exploring. If a child is scared of exploring, there are no innovations. It hinders imagination. This is not what we want. Moving swiftly on, there have been several cases in which child abuse has resulted from these corporal punishments at a time when this is banned. Imagine if corporal punishments are actually to be carried out. Look at the number of people who would exploit these opportunities and result in so many crimes taking place on a daily basis. Facts have shown that around 4,000 children below the age of 18 try to commit suicide every single day, half of which is due to physical torture or physical pressure. If corporal punishments are to take place, these will hike by a huge margin. Also, are you ready to risk the life of your own child, of the 40% of the world's population, just because you want to discipline him? As for discipline, discipline can be carried out through love, compassion, strict guidance, and correcting the person on the correct path. My opponents and my worthy opponents will of course say that discipline can only be achieved through corporal punishments. However, that is not the case. A research has shown that if corporal punishments are not carried out, a person makes correct decisions and is independent. Lastly, we might have all heard of the balance theory, which is accepted throughout the world, that if a person is forced to do right, he will be more inclined to do wrong when he grows up. This is what will happen with corporal punishments. Hence, I want to conclude that physical punishments can turn into physical torture, and corporal punishments are not what we want. Thank you.
Time for rebuttal. Questions, please.
My able debater, you said that we should ban corporal punishment because humans exploit it. But psychology says humans have the tendency to exploit anything that comes in their way. So, are you implying that we should ban mobile phones tomorrow, TVs day after tomorrow, robots? Because we are quintessentially exploiting them even today.
Firstly, I didn't say we should ban corporal punishments. I said they are being banned in many of the countries. Secondly, we should not, of course, ban mobile phones, computers, robots, because they have more advantages than disadvantages, and they do not directly risk the life. However, in corporal punishment, the case is completely different.
My worthy opponent, you mentioned that corporal punishment should be banned in many countries. But what do you think of India, a country where dons, high-profile mafias, and people are shot on the road like nothing? Do you think that banning corporal punishment would work in such a country like India?
Banning corporal punishments is completely different from shooting and mafias on the roads, of course. So banning corporal punishments will help growth of the child in all aspects of life. And I did not understand the part in which you said mafias on roads, because that didn't make sense. Thank you.
My worthy opponent, how can you justify that a person
who has not been receiving corporate punishment since childhood is likely to make the right decisions because then he has never faced any enforcement of the correct decisions.
If he receives enforcement through corporate punishments, he will grow up and have the tendency to do those wrong things even more. That's the balance theory. And if he isn't and is given strict guidance along with love and compassion, as I gave the example of Finland, it works. Research has also proved the same. Thank you.
As time is up, no more questions, please.
Thank you.